Hello all. Let us continue with our discussion of multiply and MAC unit. So multiply and MAC unit is one of the most important block of the complete DSP. And as the name implies, it is composed of an adder, a multiplier, and finally the accumulator. We can conclude that a typical MAC execution unit will execution cycle will compose of the following steps. First, we need to obtain the input signal, maybe for an FIR filter or maybe for a fast Fourier transform computation or for any signal processing application. So we have to move the input sample into the input buffer, and then this input signal has to be multiplied with a coefficient. So hence we have to fetch the coefficient from another internal buffer, multiply the input sample by the coefficient. The product has to be added to the accumulator. So, and hence the output of the accumulator, which is a final output, has to be moved to the output buffer. And this should be sent out as a whole to the output signal. So this accumulator goes on performing this accumulation as and when new samples are obtained again and again. So the same thing is elaborated. The MAC unit execution cycle is represented here in its hardware architecture. So we can see that the input sample, let it be considered as X, and the coefficient, let us assume that it is stored in Y, in register which is of length N bit. So the first sample of input X and the first sample of first coefficient of input Y are multiplied by means of a multiplier, and the product in general will be 2N bits. This 2N bits are initially added to the accumulator output, which is initially 0, and the resultant accumulator output will be 2n. Whenever an addition operation is obtained, there will be an extra bit that is obtained due to the carry operation. So during the first operation, we get 2n plus 1, and the resultant value is stored in the accumulator register, and finally the result is moved on to the output buffer. However, this operation continues for continuous input samples and the coefficient. For the next set of input sample and the coefficient, again the multiplier operation is done, and the previous value of the result is added with the 2n bits, and subsequently the carry bits grow in size. So these carry bits are also called as guard bits or precision bits, which go on increasing in size as the number of input samples and the filter coefficients are obtained. Hence, the final result after all the input samples and coefficients are obtained is stored in the output buffer. So the entire process that we have discussed now are explained over here. So a complete n-bit cross n-bit multiplication and its addition with an adder, and the storing the first iteration of the result into an output buffer, all has to be achieved in a single clock cycle. And then we have already discussed about the extra guard bit, which arises whenever an addition operation is happening, and as the number of input samples are added, this guard bit grows in size. The desired features of a MAC are finally summarized as follows. The speed of the MAC should be faster and better. The input format of the MAC should be in such a manner that it should be able to accommodate a 2's complement or unsigned or fractional or integer or any data format. This MAC should also be compatible with the output precision, either as a single precision or double precision operations, based on whether it is a fixed point or floating point. And for high throughput, this MAC unit should support a pipelined multiplier, where we need not wait for the input samples to come one by one. Hence, parallel operation can be performed if we obtain a pipeline multiplier where input samples and coefficients can be taken up in parallel. Appropriate number of extension bits should be provided in the accumulator for fixed point representations. So let us see a MAC implementation for an FIR filter. We all very well know that Y of n is equal to summation k equal to 0 to n minus 1 h of n star x of n minus k. where h of n stands for the filter coefficients or the impulse response of the filter. X of n is the input sample. X of n minus 1, x of n minus 2 up to x of n minus k are all the delayed samples of x of n. And n represents the number of taps. So here, for a second order FAR filter, we can see that n value will be equal to 3. That is, the number of taps will be equal to 3. And k value will be equal to 0 to 2. So x of n, delayed, we get x of n minus 1. And again, you delay, you get x of n minus 2. And when we try to implement this for y of n equal to summation k equal to 0 to 2. So we get the equation y of n equal to h of 0 into x of n plus x of 1 into x of n minus 1 plus h of 2 into x of n minus 2. So when we implement this onto our particular hardware, we realize a second order FAR filter in this manner. In the same manner, an equation for a 9-tap FAR filter is given as such. We can see that x of n is the input and the x of n is delayed 1 by 1 until x of n minus 8 for a 9-tap FAR filter. And finally, so the number of taps specifies the number of multiplications that we are going to perform and additions that has to be performed simultaneously. So x of n represents the input samples and h of 0 up to h of 8 represents the filter coefficients. So as per the equation, the first input sample x of n and h of 0 are multiplied and then the initial accumulator value is 0 and this multiplied product is added and which is nothing but the output of the first MAC, which is x of n into h of 0. This output of the MAC is preserved for the next stage where x of n minus 1 and h of n is multiplied and then it is accumulator or added with the previous value of the MAC to produce the second MAC output, second cycle operation of this MAC. It goes on producing until the seventh cycle operation. Finally, every time the output gets stored in a buffer. And after the complete input samples are processed, the final output is moved from the output buffer onto the final output register. So an nth order FAR filter implementation in general is given. So every time a filter coefficient and input sample is moved to a register, it is multiplied and the resultant product is added and stored in an accumulator. And finally, the resultant is stored in the output y of n. Thank you.